My name is Jordan Casson, and in this video, I will be giving a basic introduction to SWOOD scripting. I will discuss what an if statement is, how to use them, and also how the PC reads the script to understand more about how to structure them. I will first show how to add a comment to a script, as it will help show you through the scripts in SWOOD. To add a comment, simply start your sentence with an apostrophe. This will turn the text green, telling SWOOD not to include this text in any scripting calculations. You may be wondering what an if statement is at this point. An if statement is used to create conditions which can drive different aspects of SWOOD models. An if statement must always start with an if, like shown on screen. In this example, if the variable A is set to 100, then SWOOD will set B to 200 and C to 300. These variables, as mentioned, can be set up to drive different parts of SWOOD models, for example, dimensions. SWOOD reads the scripts line by line. Therefore, you need to write your script in order. For example, in this script, SWOOD will check if A equals 100. If it does, then it reads through the statement underneath. If it does not equal 100, then it will ignore the statement underneath and jump to the next if statement. Any following if statements, which are referencing the same calculation, need to be scripted as else if. For example, if A equals 200, then SWOOD will read the first if statement, realize that A does not equal 100, and jump to the else if statement. SWOOD will then recognize that A equals 200, and then set B to 400 and C to 600. It is worth mentioning that all if statements must be finished with an end if, otherwise this will cause errors in your script. When scripting, you don't have to be this specific, as this script will only allow A to be 100 or 200. If we wanted to accept values up to 100 and up to 200, we could use a less than symbol in our script. SWOOD scripting allows less than and greater than symbols, which can be used in a couple of ways. If I wanted the script to set B to 200 and C to 300, if A was less than 100, then I can script this statement as follows using a less than symbol. This means that if A is any value less than 100, but not equal to 100, then SWOOD will set B and C to 200 and 300. The same can be applied to the else if statement below, making that accept values less than but not equal to 200. Remember that it will have run the 100 if statement first, therefore values less than 200 have to be greater than 100. By putting an equals symbol after the less than symbols, the script will then accept values up to and including 100 for the first statement, and also up to and including 200 for the second statement. These are known as less than or equal to symbols. Logic can also be used in if statements for the condition inputs. In the first condition of the script shown, if A is 100 or B is 200, then C is 200 and D is 300. If that condition is not met, the script will check if A is 200 or if B is 400 for the next condition. By using OR in the script, the program allows two separate values that do not need to be set at the same time. If the program requires both values to be set for the conditions, we can use AND instead. This instructs the program to only use the condition if both values are set at the same time. For the last script, I will demonstrate using variables to find other variables with a calculation. In this example script, if A is less than or equal to 100, then B will be set to 200 and C will be 2 times A plus B. This will make C change its value relative to A. For instance, if we inputted A as 100, it would evaluate C using the calculation on screen, giving a value of 400. Thank you for watching. If you would like to learn more about scripting or how to create variables for scripting, feel free to check out our website and YouTube channel.